should say good morning or good afternoon. Our Father, our God, Jehovah, has a name that is above every name. Let it be our posture right now at this time, before we begin bring our requests, our complaints, or before we even intercede, let's acknowledge Him, His greatness, and our hearts say, holy or hallowed be thy name. Holy, holy, Lord, you're worthy, and I'm honored to sing your glory, God Almighty, hallowed be your name.
Thank you so much, Dr. and Mrs. Foster. I love that song. I really do love that song. Hallowed would be thy name. Lord, you are holy. Lord, you are mighty. You know, all of what we've said that is not due is full work until it begins to take its root in you. If you're listening to me today, maybe you've gotten away from God. And sometimes in our busy lives, we do. We're so busy rushing. We're so busy doing for others. Sometimes we're so busy ministering that we forget to connect with the one that it's all about. This time is part of what this is for. This is where those greater 19. To seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all the things that we need will be added unto us. And I pray today that if you've never made Jesus the Lord of your life, that you would just pray this simple prayer. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Be my Lord, be my Savior. I realize that I'm a sinner and I fall short of your glory. I accept now your righteousness as my righteousness before God. Listen, if you would just pray this simple prayer, you have begun the process of discipleship. Discipleship is a lifelong adventure. It does not begin and end with a simple prayer, but you begin with a simple prayer. It's not the end of a simple prayer, you begin with a simple prayer. Let me tell you again, Lord Jesus, come into my life, be my Savior, and be my Lord. I realize that I've sinned and I've come short of your glory. I ask you to be my righteousness and my right standing before God. That's what it takes to begin this lifelong journey of discipleship, of following Jesus, of letting him be the Lord of your life. If you've never done that, please do that today. While you're there, while the band's not playing, while you're not around all your friends to persuade you, while you're in that moment of isolation, because you know what? When all of us stand before God, we will stand before God by ourselves. There won't be anybody else to reference us. There'll be us and the books. And the books are going to be accurate. So please, if you've never made a decision for Jesus Christ, make that decision today. If you have gotten away from God, and COVID-19 has helped point you to a greater 19, come back. Come back. If you're angry at somebody without a cause, or even if you have a good right to be angry, you know what? What we've done before God, how we've sinned before him, is greater than what anybody's ever done to you. Forgive them. Forgive them. Forgive them. Not just for their sake, mostly for yours. Because you can't move on until you're ready to cut off that from your past. Cut off that unforgiveness. Cut off that not speaking to somebody and going out of your way to avoid somebody. That's ridiculous. All those steps you're taking going around, trying not to see somebody, you're just wasting. Go the direct path. Short as the distance between two lines, it's two points, it's usually a straight line. We learned that back when I was a kid in mathematics class. You know what? You're stuck in a house. Maybe you're stuck in an environment where you don't want to be, people you don't want to be in. Particularly if they're your family. Take the time to get to know them. You would be surprised what may be lurking in their hearts. Good things that you did not discover because until this time. Take that time. Maybe a husband or a wife. Maybe a son or daughter. Maybe a brother or sister. Maybe a grandfather, grandmother, whatever the relationship is. Take the time to get to know people. We'll be here again this coming Wednesday at 7 o'clock while we study the study of the book of Romans. And then again, God willing, next Sunday. We pray that today's broadcast has been a blessing for you. That's the only reason we're here, is to be a blessing. And so, if God has spoken to you, use what God has said. Use it. Allow it to work in your life. And may he be glorified. And may you be built up because of it. Thank you so much again for watching. God bless you. God keep you until we see you again.